in the Lux Hotel here in Beverly Hills for the LD Microcap Conference. And joining us now is Emiliano Aloi, the president and CEO of Exactus. Nice to meet you. How are you?
Very good. Thank you. How are you?
Good. Today? Doing well. Exactus, a fairly new company. Tell me a bit about this company.
Well, it is very new. I mean, we've accomplished a lot in this year. This is our starting year. In Q1, we decided to redirect the company into the CBD market.
Yeah.
We rolled in Seed to Med, our largest shareholder, as a supplier, and also to get their management expertise, of which I was part, and then I transitioned into management.
Yeah.
We farmed our first crop, which went very well, in Southern Oregon, 200 acres. We had an extremely successful harvest. We picked up more than 30,000 pounds of top smokable flower and close to 200,000 pounds of processable biomass.
Wow.
And that gives us the launch pad that we need to make all the product lines. Then throughout the year, we launched our first products. We acquired the Green Goddess Extracts line.
Okay.
We rebranded and reformulated it with full traceability, which is one of our core competencies. Mm-hmm. We acquired Livor Collection, cosmetics and beauty line based on hemp extracts as well.
Right.
And now this quarter we're launching our Paradise line, and we're looking forward to a very exciting year.
Yeah,
it's been a very big first year.
Well, that's what I was saying. It's let's go through some of this, because you came on as management. What is it that you had as a vision for this year when you take over? Because obviously you looked at everything and thought, okay, where do we have to get to? So what was your vision for the year?
Well, the most important thing was to achieve a traceable product that the consumer feels safe with, in a market where there's a lot of unknown. There are lots of unknown factors, and the end user today is a little, they're a little afraid of what it is that's in that bottle.
Right.
What will it do? And we wanted to create a product that's compliant at the highest level for human consumption, and that we have, and that's the biggest achievement that we set out to achieve, and we got it. So that's a very good thing. We're establishing a name now as arguably one of the most transparent companies in the space.
Yeah.
By way of sharing with our customers exactly what's in that bottle, and that's really what we wanted, and create that platform to go into further scalability for next year.
Was it by choice to only release a small number of products in year one to make sure that you got it right? Because you only have a chance to make a first impression once, right?
True. Well, you could say it was by choice. It was really a result of the thoroughness with which we create any single product.
Right.
So it takes time. We just couldn't do more.
Yeah.
So by choice, we did as much as we could, but with the bar of quality very high.
Yeah.
So that made the rollouts to be a little slower, but then those are products that stick to the market, that the client likes, that the client doesn't send back. And they say that the fastest thing to do something is once.
Right. Now tell me about Oregon and what's going on with your grow there. That's is it a big facility?
Well, it's a 200 acre farm. We have our own drying capabilities, which is a very big thing in the hemp
market. Absolutely.
Because mold and mildew are the big enemy of the hemp farmer.
Yeah.
And we have a 20,000 square foot facility where we do the drying. Now in Florida, we just started build out on a 56,000 square foot facility.
Oh wow! Okay.
Where we're going to do final formulations, post processing, and packing. A lot of the quality of the product is defined in the last stage.
Right.
So we're trying to own that by way of, creating a raw material to the highest standards and then finishing the product to the highest standards.
Right. What markets do you see as big ones for you in 2020? Where do you want to be into in the United States?
Well, right now we are getting very strong in the sublingual and the cosmetics markets. We're going to see that growing.
Okay.
I believe there's going to be a huge leap on the food divisions as soon as the FDA finalizes the regulations on how to make hemp a food.
Right.
And we are doing a considerable investments in growing that division for when it's ready. And we're getting into the more medical markets by our agreement with a company called Cantab Therapeutics.
Yes.
Which we are, working together. We're subleasing a space in our facility. Mm-hmm. They are bringing in proprietary technology in time release and, instant release, extended release, and precision dosage of cannabinoids. So we see that as an upgrade in the pedigree of our final products, because now we can prove not only our purity and traceability, but also, we can prove precision dosage at the end, which is something that the customer is looking for.
Yeah, and that's an interesting market, because we talk about you know, the opioid crisis and what's going on with that. And I've interviewed Richard Goldstein many, many times from Cantab. I know him very well. I know the company very well. So we talk about that with him, the fact that this is a not sort of a business move. This is a societal move that to get away from opioids. And being on the leading edge of that is going to be a massive thing.
I agree. And the you know, the opioid crisis, it's more than just a crisis. I mean, it's a type of medicine that doesn't cure. It just hacks the brain to make it not feel the pain. So right. So it carries the risk that the user continues damaging himself by way of not feeling. Whereas, you know, cannabinoid therapy is designed to actually attack the molecule and get to cure ailments, you know, particularly inflammation, which is the beginning part of almost every illness that we know.
Sure, yeah. Well, it's an exciting time. I'm interested to see how it works with Cantab and what 2020 looks like. Great to meet you. Thank you for
coming.
Great
to meet you too.
Yeah, it's Emiliano Aloi. He's the president and CEO of Exactus.